Soul of Guts. The soul of Lord Gwyn's knight Guts, who was consumed by the Abyss. The legend that Artorias repelled the Abyss only told half the story. It seems that he was defeated and his honor preserved by some unsung hero who is the true victor over the Abyss. Oh, really?
So,
by beating him, I preserve his honor?
So, here's the thing. So, in all the story that's in-game prior to the DLC, man, Artorias kicked the Abyss's ass super hard. He's the best. He has the Covenant of the Abyss. He can Abyss walk. He's the fucking shit. He kicked the Abyss's ass. And then you get here, and what's he like?
He's melting.
And his arm is broken, and he's using the wrong arm, and he's a beast.
Yeah.
So,
he's screaming at you.
He clearly lost the fight with the Abyss.
Mm-hmm. But like, didn't die.
No, well, I mean...
Because that didn't seem...
You did it.
But, like, that didn't seem like he was,
hollow. No, no.
Like that. You know,
he's probably not even undead.
How did you get in here?
That was the guy that...
That's what he threw
at you.
Yeah.
Right.
Oh, boy.
Woo!
Good fight, man.
Good big fights!
Look at all the residue you left behind.
Gooey! Delicious!
Gooey.
Now, luckily...
I hear the sounds.
Yeah, nope, those are not what you think they are. They're just ambient noises.
Oh.
Luckily for you, you maintained all of your humanity.
Yeah, I kept picking it back up.
Oh, dude, normally I wouldn't try and backseat on this, but there's a bonfire straight out on that courtyard.
Straightforward?
Yep.
Okay.
And the resources that you're carrying around are a little nerve-wracking there.
Cheers!
Oh, boy. Whew!
So,
I don't remember if in this game his sword is denoted as having being left-handed. That may have been something that was added, like, going forward.
That would be a mistake if they didn't.
So, here's the question, Wolves.
Go ahead.
You probably want to kindle this a couple times, probably.
Sure.
And the question is, do you want to use that for levels? Or do you want to get new fancy clothes?
So here's what I was going to ask is, you know, Artorias' set isn't going to be found lying somewhere around this world.
No. There's a guy you can go buy it from.
Is it Donald?
Yes.
Let's take a look at it. Then.
Yes.
Let's at least take a look at it. Come on.
No, you're good. This place just sucks shit.
I'm at a bonfire, bro. All right.
Fuck y'all.
This is a sensible Kindle?
Oh, yeah. Maybe not all the way, but definitely a couple, because this is a good... It is a good spot. It's a good spot right here.
Well, it's on my body anyway, so I got nowhere else to put it.
Is this the last bonfire? I think this might be the last bonfire in the DLC.
I got nowhere else to put it.
I got nowhere else to go.
I'll tell you where you can put... What is this?
I don't know.
That's post-boss montage... Giggles.
yeah.
Quickly, to Dommel of Xena of Welshland. You know why Wales gets no respect? Because nobody knows that it exists.
Because it's called Wales.
I have Welsh in me, and I barely know where the fucking place is.
You know, if they threw an H on there, everyone would love them that much more.
Walsh?
No, Wales. W-H-A-L-E-S. Imagine how cool that would be.
You said if you throw an R on there.
I said an H. You misheard for some reason. Dude, I was trying to say that if their name...
Doesn't it have H?
No, it's W-A-L-E-S. Do you not know how to spell whales? Apparently not. Yeah.
I'm having a moment.
Whales. W-A-L-E-S. Look it up.
I'm having a moment where my brain is just...
You thought it was the same as the animal?
No, I didn't! But I thought it was... For some reason, when you said add an H, I'm like, isn't it W-A-H-L-E-S? Or...
It is not.
I don't know.
It is not.
Help. Man, I feel like sometimes my brain just fails me.
Sometimes.
Like, it doesn't do the...
Fuck you.
It doesn't do the thing that it's supposed to do. It just remember things and think. Think good. Big. Oh, no.
Hey, friend.
Hey, bro.
Hey, Shemai. I didn't expect to meet anybody here. I suppose great minds think alike, eh?
So this is the one that completely breaks all logic of the in-game universe.
How?
He traveled into the past to get this shit.
The answer is, like, don't think about it. He's just the vendor that has got this shit. 2020. Wow. All right. You're not making that on a whim.
No.
If you buy that, you better wear it.
Let's see its stats, because I believe it is much...
Hold up.
Well,
anything new in this lore?
Yes, the death of the helm's owner can be surmised from the corrosive dark of the abyss, and the musty azure blue tassel, once a symbol of pride and glory.
So, he lost to the abyss.
Hard.
And then the incarnation of the abyss, or the dark lord, quote-unquote, beat him. Mm-hmm. So he lost to the abyss again.
Oh, snap. Well, that is if you're going for the Dark Lord ending,
I guess.
But yeah, regardless. Oh, snap. It's so the helmet's 18 health, right?
Okay, 18.
Oh, you know what? Use the chest. It's the easiest.
Yeah, 42.
So 42, 10.5. You know, because you look at the weight as well.
Yeah. So my current one is it
much higher?
Yeah. So let's 61, I think.
Let's check that out. 42, 10.5.
Well,
because what it might be is what it might be is that it's much, much lighter. Because think of what Artorias was doing. Mm-hmm. He's flying around and shit. You gotta go into the actual.
70
and 12. So somewhat lighter. And this would only matter if you were right on the threshold for 25%. Which, if we go into your overall stats, I bet you're not.
No, well, it's pretty armor, but
hit RB, would you, for me? It'll help me do the math. Just RB once. There you go.
I was afraid of an attack for a second. I was like...
No, this will not kick you down into the lower form of roll.
Also, I'm not really, like, I'm fine with a mid-roll. I don't need a letter roll. And,
No, but what I mean is if you put that on, you would gain no advantage.
Yeah.
at all.
And I don't think it's as pretty.
Oh, really? Huh.
Here's what I like, though. That's the thing. It's a very close race, right?
Yeah.
And tattered cloth added...
Oh, don't even bother with the jumps. Just bone out.
I was about to bone out.
Yeah.
Tattered cloth really adds a lot to a detail, right? Like, I'm not going to pretend it doesn't. But something about that helmet can't be denied.
Are you saying that I would look cooler if my clothes were in rags?
No, because that would expose your fleshy bits. And no one
listen,
needs that. No one needs
my
that.
Fleshy bits are awesome.
You...
What, you don't want some of this?
No.
The hand movements I'm doing that unfortunately people can't see at home...
I think the planet Earth has collectively decided that
really...
they don't want none.
Oh, hun.
let's see, what can I pop? Eight?
Eight?
Might be holding eight.
Maybe.
I might be holding eight. Yeah, I something that, like, the tattered cloth looks cool, but goddamn, that Ornstein helmet is
a
winner.
Well, it also helps that you're wearing, you're using, like, a weapon that, like, I don't know how much that's going to give you, but fuck it, let's see. You're wearing a weapon. Oh, wait, hey!
Perfect.
You might need one more, because you might be, like, 300 off or some shit.
Watch it be that.
You're like, 89 off.
Barely, yeah. Again, I need to just go lick somebody.
That I shouldn't have done that. That was gross to do. Don't.
Okay.
That's
The other thing I'm gonna do is fucking just drop this
crap
right in here.
Get this fucking shit out of my fucking house.
Right in here. Anything else I need to drop? I don't think so. I didn't pick up that much.
Oh, a little piece of trivia. You know the little bridge that you went in after Chester to walk into the boss room, like where the fog gate is?
Yeah.
That's the spot where the majority of the Giant Dad video take place. Also the spot that you're here, where you're sitting at right now, this bonfire.
I see.
So there's a really goofy aspect of this DLC, and I'm gonna guess you never even heard of it, and that is that this DLC was the first time that they said, oh, people actually want to PvP, like,
crazy.
Like organized, mm-hmm. like they want duels, so behind you and down one of those corridors is the first implementation of, like, the dueling arena.
Ah, the very first one?
Yes. And the problem was, is that when it came out, all the soul level matchmaking in it were not along the lines of what the PvP community had decided was the average soul level to meet in PvP, and what every build had been based on. So nobody used it.
It was weird.
Instead, people would hang out where you are sitting right now, 10 feet away from the real arena, and invade instead, or use the fucking dueling soapstein.
They tried.
They'll get it one day.
I mean, they already got
it. I think DS3 added it.
Yeah, they already got a couple of those.
Yeah, DS2 was probably the most successful it ever was, really, with the PvPs.
Although the new thing in 3, where it's literally just versus mode,
yeah,
is pretty hard to deny.
I would love a netcode enhanced, like, versus mode with this thing, where it actually worked. Where it actually worked like it was supposed to.
Let's see, okay. Let's go downstairs this time, then.
What? It's the Battle of Stoicism Gazebo.
Oh, is that what that's called? Three types of Battle of Stoicism matches. 1v1, 2v2, 4v1. Okay, yeah. Okay.
They tried.
No kidding. And this is the leaderboard.
The plaque of legends. Who's the dual legend? Kai.
Good job,
with
Kai.
With a 26 streak.
And Becky, half that, less than half of that. Wow.
Damn. I wonder how many of these people are cheaters.
Well, this guy maybe, but these guys are all close, so maybe they're honest. Becky's a beast. Maybe they're all cheaters.
Let me smear.
Maybe they're all cheaters.
They don't want blue.
And so you just kneel here and do the thing.
You kneel at the deathmatch dais.
And you select the... Yeah, okay. So,
That's a really goofy implementation. I don't like it at all. I think the DS2 implementation of all the PvP stuff was way better.
Is that no one could really confirm, or rather, soul levels were all out of whack?
Yeah, basically. And also, the matchmaking was not good either.
Hey, I'm in the city.
You're on top of that big tower.
Up on the roof.
Yeah.
Got some statues.
Give me that soul of a hero, bro.
We got a death drop. No, we got to drop back into where we came from.
Nah, it's just like a drop, you know, like
All right, and these they're all holding branches.
Yeah, because Ulusiel, they're holding their fancy little white branch catalysts.
That's what they do.
Ulusiel's a nice place.
I hate the name, but it's a nice place. I hate the name.
It's so weird. Like, hey, look, this place in Dark Souls, what a nice place.
Yeah.
Well, it's not nice anymore. But
I'd never want to come from anywhere with two O's simultaneously in it.
Oh, really?
Yeah. O and O are such ugly letters to put back to back.
Oh, you got a problem with O?
Two O's together?
Damn, it's locked.
How ugly is that?
Damn, boy.
If anyone ever had a name,
you're throwing down.
If anyone ever had a name with two O's in it back to back, that'd be the worst
thing
ever.
That'd be disgusting.
I'd vomit all over.
That's the joke. The joke is your name is Dooley.
Fake vomiting noises are never as good
never
as real
as bad.
Vomiting
They're
noises.
They're never as bad.
Because you can't hear the liquid interrupting.
Oh, I have a tip for you.
Yep.
So back where Chester was, there was actually a path that your eyes did not see.
There was...
Oh, also, hey.
What the fuck?
Ha
ha! Are you human? I forgive you. I am here to pay respects to a dear friend. Please... allow me a moment alone.
The one whose blood is on the tip of my spear?
Shut up!
Are you human? I forgive you. I am here to pay respects to a dear friend. Please, allow me
a
moment alone.
Does she not talk to you if you're human?
Is that what it is? I was about
That might actually be it. That's...
I was gonna say, is my faith too low, or...
No? Okay.
Huh. All right, we'll find out what...
I'll look that up.
Lady, I won't be human for too long, so don't worry about it, huh?
Eh.
Hey, Simile. Yeah, so what I didn't do... No, I walked over here already. What I didn't do was... or did I?
Oh, that's why. Okay, I'll tell you next time you're at a bonfire.
Okay, so what I didn't do was explore the area...
Down here.
No, upstairs too.
Oh, upstairs as well. Yes, you're right. So, I'll be honest, there's not all that much upstairs.
Was an item or two?
Yeah, nothing crazy. The main thing is the path that's right there to your left.
Ah, that's a really hidden one.
Sure is.
Let's go upstairs for a sec.
Okie dokie. Man, that is a cool
little lion, man.
I
mean, look at the necklace, like, part of it, too. You can't pretend.
There's so many details that I forget. Oh, hey, guys.
You can't pretend. Fight or run. Fight or run.
You used up all your souls. So the only thing you'd be losing is your human form.
Let's make it quick.
Well, off we go. Oh, it might be real quick. Real, real quick. Hey, look, there's an item, hopefully.
Yes, it is.
Congrats. You explored this section, pretty much.
Oh.
Not even joking.
Wait.
No. Oh, but there's stuff up there.
There is an up.
And I love the color palette of the sky here. Such a nice orange. Oh, the big guys seem to have stopped. But the last time we thought that... Okay, no, they're just slow.
They're slow. They're really slow. But they're coming. They're coming. Don't you worry.
Are they coming back? Boy, why is it that when I went on Twitter and I saw you responding to some, like, spotlight on Grenada...
Yeah, it was a really cool video.
And you're like, excuse me... while I dump ass on this,
it was a really good,
good feeling moment.
I showed it to my mom and she freaked out. She's like, oh my god, it's amazing. What a nice video.
All notable Grenadians also include guy with machete in my room who says, I'm coming back.
he's, what was it? He's, how old were you that one?
Oh man, I don't know.
Like young, like 10.
Really
right?
Young, yeah. There's a word for that experience. You know what that word is?
Traumatizing?
Formative.
That's another one.
It's a pivotal moment in your youth that helps define who you're going to be as an adult.
At least a little bit.
Like when my mom told me that the good guys don't always win during an episode of the Power Rangers.
Oh. But was it a two-parter?
Yeah, it was the Green Ranger.
Yeah, that's... there you go.
But you know, the Green Ranger came out and fucking kicked their ass so hard. Wasn't even close, right?
It was really devastating.
And I'm like, Mom, what happens if the Power Rangers don't win? They have to win. And she goes, sometimes the good guys lose.
Yeah.
And I went, and I'm like, 7. And I'm like, I can't handle that knowledge. That's too much.
In fact, most of the time they lose.
Oh.
But yeah, he's waiting. He's Bok. I never came back. That's how you defeat him.
Do you ever think about, like, that guy's probably, like, old now?
Probably had some kids. Little family.
You think he tells them the story of how he scared the shit out of some kid with a machete?
Yeah. And then the whole time, the kid was waiting for him to come back. So that's why that...
How long did you think that was he was going to come back for?
Oh, well, enough to the point where we called the police and... Oh, Jesus.
Not normal. Oh, that's not how that enemy is supposed to move. That is not how that enemy is supposed to move.
I don't believe you. I don't believe. I'm pretty sure that's exactly how it's supposed to move. I'm seeing exactly what the developer intended here. Here comes another one.
Speaking of developer intended, this is a bit off topic. You see those Mass Effect patches?
I didn't. What are they?
They're turning the game into an early access game.
Come on. What does that mean?
That means that, like, they fixed the eyes, and they're adding a bunch of, like, they put out a statement going, hey, we're really excited. Here's the patch roadmap.
Okay, piece by piece.
Right? Okay. And it's like, really?
What else is there?
Oh, there's too much to name. They're adding more romance options for gay dudes. They're fixing a lot of the weird writing shit.
Hey, man, it's either that or abandon on your expensive... Part 2. Ah, DLC, you're so cinematic.
I love you, DLC.
You're so clearly, like... You're doing much more than the normal game, so that it feels like a special experience, because the player has to feel that it was worth it.
Dude, I love that. I love when
you have to pay more attention to direction and detail.
I love when you go into a DLC and you can tell that because it's extra, the people behind it just got like a little bit of more room to stretch, right? They got just a little bit more room to just do something a little odd. Reminds me of New Vegas. They have 4 DLCs for that.
And this is a wide open area.
And all 4 of those DLCs.
And that's the reason why. That makes sense.
Yeah.
Yeah. I could see that.
Yeah.
I'm like, how come the, like, either that or the boss, like, life bar.
No.
No.
So, he's going to be tough to beat in that form.
Yeah.
So don't worry about that.
There's one more item down there. I think it was just a soul.
Probably. And there was a. You could have gone backwards when you went down the thing. I don't really see much of a problem going back down for another little scrapey.
Scrapey scrape. Maybe now. Hey, baby. Hey, I got rid of all that nasty clawing, gnawing humanity.
Woo!
Maybe this time.
Are you human? I forgive you.
So go back to the bonfire and take out Artorias' soul.
Oh. Ooh, is that a good idea? I guess so.
Do you want a big-ass greatsword?
Not really.
No, okay, great. Then grab Artorias' soul.
Okay. Yeah.
Because you'll get something that I can guarantee you'll like better. I guarantee.
Hey, man, you know what's fucking radical?
What's that?
Twin greatswords.
Yeah.
You seen those gifts?
I have. I have seen that shit.
The man who fell on this spot? He was a dear friend. I wish to pay proper respect with that soul. Would you be willing to part with it?
I don't know. I wanna use it to gain 1,000 souls.
16,000.
Want to use it to make a boss weapon?
Nah. You can make the Abyss greatsword with it.
You make his big sword.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
And there's you can make like 3 versions of that sword, but I mean they're all great swords.
Please take this. I no longer need it.
But instead, you got the dark silver and gold tracers.
May the Lord guide thee.
Okay.
She got more to say? No. Nah, okay. Her weapons will tell you way more about her.
I would assume.
She's cool.
Seems.
She's really cool.
Seems kind of normal. Let's find out. Dark Silver Tracer, 75. This thing is amazingly dex scaled.
Yes, it is.
Good, 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 good.
Crit, by the way, is 160%.
Ridiculous crit level. Yeah, so it's probably got the whatchamacallit there, the dex, like, fucking curved sword
set. Ah, a dark silver dagger used by Lord Blades Kirin of Gwyn's Four Knights. The victim is first distracted by dazzling streaks of the gold tracer, then stung by the vicious poison of this dagger.
Ah, you two-handed. Yes. Are you sure that's not, Ciarin?
No, I'm pretty sure it's Kirin.
They say it.
At some point, someone says it. What's funny is when I was typing in Kirin into Google to find out exactly how to trigger this, like, one of the results that comes up is Kirin pronunciation. And the gold tracer. Let's see. Curved sword used by the Lord's Blade Kirin, one of Lord Gwyn's Four Knights. Kirin brandishes her sword in a mesmerizing dance, etching darkness with dire streaks of gold.
Whoa, hold on a minute. You're important.
That's one of Gwyn's Four Knights.
You're a big deal.
Yep.
You're just gonna chill?
Yep. So Artorias, Kirin,
unknown.
Artorias, Kirin, fucking what's his name? The guy you're wearing the armor, Ornstein.
And
who's the fourth guy? Oh, Goth.
Can't be Smoke.
Smoke's number 5 as a bonus.
But he doesn't really count.
But he doesn't count.
This too.
These are dex weapons.
Holy shit.
And they have unique movesets. So feel free to fuck with these.
Yeah, that's a nice little pair you got there, lady. Giving them up, aren't you like? Oh wait, what am I doing? You sure you don't want to fucking hold on to these?
Nah, man, she's good.
Her and Artorias were like a a thing.
Are you sure about that?
I'm pretty sure about that one, actually.
That feels like you're making it up. Okay, hold up. Let's take a second here to see what we're working with. That's really stylish. And that's off of one button press, by the way.
Yeah, it is. So that's a pretty standard.
Yep.
What's your R2? I want you to do that sideways so we get the look of what that stab actually is. It's like a real, like, ugh.
Yeah, impale. And then... Wow, these are awesome.
And you can switch the hands around to get different results.
Right, okay.
No, I mean, like...
No, I know.
Yeah,
I just wanted to see what would happen.
Fucking... Because there's no... yeah. So these is like... And these are twinkling weapons, I believe.
Are they twinkling? Sadly, they don't really, like, they don't target combo into each other.
No, because that was a feature that pretty much gained more and more popularity the farther the series went.
Yeah.
And I actually adore the Dark Souls 3 way of doing it, which is just, no, the weapon is a two-weapon thing.
Yeah.
Like, that's just how it works. So that's the scimitar moveset from DS2, I think.
Uh-huh, that's about the same. No, it's not. It's got a follow-up. Wow, versatility. What a cool moveset. Is this good in PvP? Because it's
I don't fucking know.
It's got so much going on.
Hey, look at that! It keeps a parry!
It keeps a parry.
And you get a little stabby, just a little...
Out of it, it's a little attack, too.
Yeah.
Man, wow. Okay, that's a... Yeah, if I ever... I'd really consider rocking this for funsies. Like, that's off. The two of those together are fucking cool, and they give you a parry just for that exact purpose. That's nice. I like her shit. Weird that she'd be just chilling here, willing to part with it.
I'm checking what you actually upgrade with it.
But I guess...
Oh my god, I forgot.
He was such a big dick.
I forgot the fucking strong attack on the... on the dark tracer inflicts toxic.
Which attack?
The stab on the dark silver inflicts toxic. Not poison.
Oh.
Toxic.
Yeah. No, I would seriously consider playing around with that in a shieldless
mode. And it does, in fact, build up with twinkling titanite.
Wait. I was running back this way.
So my advice to you would be, if you want to play around with those, stay a little later one day, or come a little early one day, and buy some Twinkling Titanite. Right?
Who sells it again?
The Giant in N. Orlando. Because, yes, those weapons feel like apologies to Dex users for not having, like a bunch of cool scimitar weapons.
No, that is the coolest I've seen of that set type so far. I absolutely think those are radical dex weapons. Because the versatility is what you would expect to make up for the lack of
strength. Can use them in all sorts of ways. You can have you can have anything on your right hand and the dark silver on your left so that you have a dedicated parry and you have that nice stab. You could have the gold one on your right. You could have the gold. You know, you can mix and match with anything.
I wish there was a quick way to swap left to right and right to left.
Yeah, know? Unfortunately.
That'd be a really cool thing to do in the middle of battle. But, yeah, that's what I would want, is that you trade off big honking slab of rock or metal damage for a versatile moveset.
Love it.
What are these things sticking up out of it?
I don't fucking know. Oh, they're goo. They're abyss goo.
Oh, just crystallized and honking.
Yeah, just crystallized abyss goo.
You fucking... Look at you. Mobile little doggo.
So yeah, like you could just raw swap one of those out for like your Uchi if you got it upgraded.
Good.
And yeah, they have like disgusting deck scaling.
Yeah, no, the S and A.
There are very, very, very few weapons in Dark Souls that have S scaling.
No,
of any kind.
Yeah, no.
It was a lot more common in deaths.
Like, not even looking at the how strong they would be to wield. I already like the moveset.
Hey, man. Let's take a second to give appreciation for a weird little Japanism that Wooly and I and Matt a door. And that's, what's better than A plus?
S!
I don't know why I think that is so cool.
And the fact that S, what's better than S?
Miracle.
Alternatively, SS.
And what's better than that? SSS.
I love it.
That is a real drop.